don't shake the
chair. I know.
Yeah.
Don't move and don't shake the chair.
Look. I'll tell you anything about doing this.
Yep. That's me.
My tie on straight.
Yeah.
You know, this is an appropriate topic today, talk about the Russian Revolution, because
are we fighting with the Russians? Well, not fighting, but Donald Trump has a little bit of issues with the Russians.
Well, that's what I was saying. People would like to know more about
what they dealing with.
Yeah, the context in terms of what you're talking about.
We finna be turning into the Soviet Union.
It does seem to be
But did you know that the Soviet Union was created, like the big professed idea was everybody gets equal rights and like everybody's just equal. Nobody's like different. Mm-hmm. Everybody has equal opportunities and equal rights and equal property and stuff. A lot like more like political figures than you'd actually think. I really agree with that. And an autocracy is where just one person just rules everything. And a lot of people agree with that too. A lot of people try to uh-huh. instill that in their country or
think
whatever.
Mr. Putin is that
Putin or Putin. Trump?
No, Putin. Is a Russian man.
I mean, he probably is.
You
know, all...
Everything you said about the Russian Revolution today, autocracy and all of that, that applies directly to Mr. Putin.
And Lenin.
And yeah, of course. Thank you and welcome to the show today. The topic today is the Russian Revolution. And we're fortunate to have with us to talk about the Russian Revolution, Alana McLaughlin. And of course, Alana, let me welcome you to the show this morning and to tell you how delighted we are to have you with us. You've not been with us on a number of occasions, but nevertheless, you are with us today. And you have selected a very, very unusual topic today, dealing with the Russian Revolution. Before we get started in the topic, Lilana, let's see if we can have you to give us some information about your background, your education, and some of the things that were important in terms of bringing you to us this morning. And by that time, we should be out of this first 6 minute segment, and then we'll have an opportunity to dive directly into the Russian Revolution. Let's do it from that perspective.
Well, as you previously stated, my name is Alana McLaughlin. I am a freshman at the Nashville School of the Arts. I play trumpet. And what really brought me here was my love for history and talking about topics that a lot of people don't know about. Like the Russian Revolution, people know of it, but people don't really know about it. And so that's my main purpose here today, to shed light on a topic that is kind of important. And, well, all historical events are important because they tie into our modern daily life in some way, shape, or form. But about me, I'm Alana McLaughlin. I am very involved in sports. Like I said, I play trumpet. I am in marching band. I cheerlead, et cetera, just things like that. And that's about it. But school comes before everything. And I'm really more of an academic-based person. So that's
very good. So let's look at the so-called Russian Revolution, Lana, and give us sort of an overview in terms of that kind of information that you're going to give us this morning dealing with this very, very important historical event?
Well, the overview of the Russian Revolution is really just the big name for two sets of revolutions. And these two revolutions kind of work together to tear down the Tsarist autocracy. And now, if you're not familiar with that, it's a type of democracy or whatever. And it's a type that basically means one person rules everything. So they rule government, they rule the people, just one big leader. If you look back in history, there were lots of forms, well, attempted forms of autocracy. Say Hitler and the Jews, he tried to kind of run everything with him just being the sole leader, not really having a government, just him. Lots of dictators try to instill an autocracy, but a lot of times it doesn't work. But as I was saying, the Russian Revolution is just a big name for that. And see, once the Russian Revolution occurred in 1917, this overthrew that autocracy that I mentioned, and this was the beginning of the Soviet Union, which would come to play in 1922.
Why don't you tell us something about how this overthrowing of this autocracy came about? What was an autocracy, and what was the name of the basic kind of thing that upheld the whole Russian situation up until that time?
Well, what upheld the Russian people was the fact that none of them had rebelled up until this revolution, this rebellion. They all sat and kind of tolerated this autocracy, this one person trying to instill beliefs and views that the Russian people didn't necessarily agree with. But they let this pass by until certain people stood up and tried to break down this barrier. And these people can be seen as the equivalent of like civil rights leaders for African Americans. As we know, civil rights leaders tore down the barrier of segregation and things like that. And they helped bring equality for their people, as the people who stood up for the Russians did. And there's so many people, more than I can name, that stood up and fought this. But in the end, these people stood up, and that's how the part one of the revolution started, because like I said, there was two revolutions. They both occurred in 1917, though. And the Russian Revolution is just a big overview of those two revolutions.
Okay, and so what we'll do, we'll take our first commercial break in a few seconds, Lana, and then we'll have an opportunity to come back and to deal with the second part of the Russian Revolution. And so essentially, you're saying that the revolution started in 1917, mm-hmm, almost immediately after what we generally call the First World War.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, it was a product in
of
a real sense of Russia's participation in the First World War. And after that war was over, then we get into that first
revolution in the Russian Revolution.
And coming primarily because of all of the destruction that occurred during the war mm-hmm in Russia itself. And so what we'll do, we'll take our first commercial, and we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.
Why it would never survive somewhere like the mm-hmm like America and stuff like that. And then after that, I'm just going to like comparing dictators and stuff.
Okay, well, you let me know. Are you just going to start comparing? I'll just follow you.
All right.
Okay, well, I'm just trying to get a pace to it and get a voice level and a depth to it.
Okay.
You make it go mm-hmm that way, and because it bring you out in reference to it, when we come back, I'll announce what we're dealing with, and mm-hmm then you can start again where you please, and we've got 8 minutes, and you deal this with this however you wish to, and if at some point you wish to bring in some information in reference to the animal farm, et cetera, anything that you want to deal with, mm-hmm, dealing with the Russian Revolution, because I think we've got a pretty good start. Mm-hmm.